So we're starting the practice in shamatha. First, you have to come with an empty mind.
亲爱的朋友，最近还好吗？抱歉，最近比较忙，所以信回晚了。之前介绍你去参加的课程，效果还好吗？希望能减轻一些你生活上的焦虑。那是我一个身在远方的朋友，能给你最好的礼物。
可能平常是一个比较自我要求的人，然后稍微有点完美主义了，我想，我想工作压力有点大啦，所以是比较紧绷的，那比较像惊弓之鸟一样，可能一点小事情就比较容易有大的反应啊，对，急性子一点。
焦虑其实是一个正常的人体反应，如果我们把它定义成一个警告的讯号，焦虑什么时候会出现，就是当人察觉到无论是来自外在或来自内在出现可能潜在的危机，那个危机未必要非常的明确，比方说像恐惧，我们已经有一个明确的恐惧对象，但焦虑不需要，它只要是察觉到潜在可能的危机，身体跟心理就会出现一连串的相应的反应。但什么时候焦虑会反而成为一个问题？我们在临床上最大的观察到的现状是，来求诊的朋友们主要的原因是焦虑被引发，但却没有适时的缓解，因此就产生了相对多的身体和心理的困扰。
那我们一般来说，就是焦虑的话，在临床上的表现哦，就会包括一些身体的症状。那像是说头晕啊，或者胸闷啊，心悸，那呼吸不过来，那或者是有些肠胃的不舒服，那有可能会变得非常的容易生气，那或者是坐立不安的这种情形。那这一般来说是焦虑的表现。那还有呢，他们会非常担心，就是好像会有不好的事情发生，那实际上可能就没有，就是非常的顺利，但是他们就会很担心这个情况。
Based on my experience, so what I feel is that one of the biggest problem of the human mind is that always they will try to see what they don't have. They cannot see what they have. So that's why my experience and with the, especially for the people who they faces the stress and who faces the anxiety in their life, to teach them to overcome overcome the stress and the reduce the anxiety. So that's why the meditation is not related with any religion idea. So meditation is one of the method of the mental exercise. So there are a lot of different type of the meditations, but the one effective meditation to reducing the stress and the anxiety is we call as a shamatha meditation that I introduce.
因为像我们放松的时候常常要么去跑步，然后要么去看电影，可是其实一直在就是在追赶一些行程，就是你就算是出国也是在想说要准备出国的东西啊，行李啊，要打包什么，就有点像一个人一直跑，脑袋永远在转啊，然后看 FB 啊，看脸书啊，然后永远在看电视，就是塞了很多讯息，就是会觉得脑袋头很吵，但是静坐之后会觉得比较安静，然后比较沉淀一点。
其实刚开始是因为我生病的关系，所以我接触了就是有关身心灵这方面的东西，对，然后里面就包含了冥想跟静坐，对，然后其实应该是说算是让我有意识的去让自己放松跟静心。
21st century, that what I feel is that the people have a lot of the pressures and anxieties because of they have a lot of the works, number one. Number two, they have, because not only the works, they have a lot of the work pressure. Number three, they have a lot of the, they feels that they cannot achieve what they need, and they feel that they cannot get what they want. First of all, that these difficulties, they will not try to find some solutions from their own side. With that following that incorrect track, try to solve their solutions. Usually in there, a lot of the unnecessary thoughts comes in our mind. That the unnecessary thought creates the anxiety and the stress. So many people feel that the stress and the worry and the anxiety is some sort of the helpless. We cannot do anything with these type of the destructive emotion. So that's why Samatha meditation is one technique to teach us how to block all these the unnecessary thoughts. So that is the one main, the purpose of the practicing Samatha.
有时候曾想，当我们听说谁投资赚了多少，谁升到什么职位，谁完成了什么，就算我们坚信自己所选择的道路，依旧会怀疑自己是否一事无成。其实要肯定自己并不是那么容易。
Close your eye and just relax. Relax means don't think anything for the moment, okay, when you close your eye.
刚才同学说我们就是坐正，然后背直，那手呢就像龙贴一样，这样轻松的放在这个大腿的上面。
So the very interesting thing is when you look at the pain, slowly the feeling of the pain you will lost. You will lose the feeling of the pain.
很特别，就是说当你去注意那个痛的时候，慢慢的痛的感觉会消失。
Feeling the worry and anxiety, you will lose the appetite. You will lose the interest to do the anything.
那觉得焦虑啊，或担心事情，这时候可能就会食欲不好，或者是对做很多事情都失去了兴趣。
So when you look like that, first there are the few steps, as I told, when you feel the worry or anxiety, first just close your eye and try to concentrate on the breath. Still the thought is disturbing. Just...
我刚开始觉得是应该是说佛教意味会很深厚很浓厚的一个活动，可是并不是，它只是纯粹的教我们就是怎么去禅修跟静坐冥想。我觉得其实心理跟生理的就是疾病甚至是病痛是很有相关联性的。其实在我得肝癣这个病的时候，我后来慢慢的去探索，我才发现其实我有很多事情是一直累积跟压抑，一些情绪是累积跟压抑，可是我以前自己不知道。
So that's why I feel that the Samatha meditation, especially this the simple meditation technique, practicing the 2 weeks, can achieve or at least some of the experience, or at least I feel that you can see some of the reduce of the stress and anxiety. We did the survey. Before receiving Samatha meditation instruction, our participants filled out questionnaires that measured their degree of anxiety and the depression. After 2 weeks of the Samatha practice, the attendees again completed the questionnaires. We then analyzed and compared questionnaires' score before and after Samatha practice. The statistics shows the degree of the both anxiety and the depression reduced significantly after 14 days. Usually the mind is have the very strong potential. Sometimes we could not use the potentials of the strength of the mind. The Samatha meditation, the technique to teach us how we can use the strength of the mind on the right purpose.
有种天生坚强的人并不了解那种每天早上醒来不想面对这个世界的感觉，甚至连承认自己软弱的力量都没有，那就把心放空吧，我们一定会找到一个办法来坚强自己，面对这个世界。
我觉得如果在睡觉之前 有稍微做一下，隔天起来那个感觉，我觉得我只能很抽象的形容，我是觉得就是有一个平静的感觉。因为我觉得这你可以把它想说是禅修嘛，有人会说是内观嘛，或者是你今天就什么都不要讲，就说是放松练习。对，但是不管是哪一种，基本上你还是要愿意去做，然后愿意相信它有可能做得到。
对我来说的放松指的是即便是在那种情况之下，你仍然不需要去想很多可能没有发生或者是即将要发生的事情，你的思考不会一直还在忙碌。然后很放松的状态甚至会有点类似比如说我们今天去海岛旅游，然后看着一望无际的大海，那种很愉快的心情，或者是像浮潜一样就是飘着，然后也不用干嘛这样。
平常的生活步调当中，你不会特别有个机会告诉自己说你要慢下来，或者是有个时间你要特别开辟一个时间给自己了，那个时候你会静下来，然后比较专注在自己的呼吸，那比较可以放空，那也会比较能够跟自己对话。我觉得
就是说你可以自己觉察到其实你已经太紧张，那你要学会放松的话，我觉得这是一个很好的方法，因为它不花钱，它你在家就可以做。然后我自己做了以后，我是觉得可以利用这个方法来放松自己。
因为我们有的时候会有一些固定的思考的模式，那个可能是每个人不同，那所以如果说我们发现到，因为我们是一个比较容易焦虑的这个体质，那我会觉得说是需要刻意去维持自己的状态的。
我刚开始还没有学会静坐跟冥想这个东西的时候，本身会不自主的会很容易紧张，然后会很紧绷整个人。对，可是我就是学了静心冥想之后，我会可以让我在我发现我很紧绷的时候，利用这个练习让我放松下来。我觉得人都是有波动，不可能一直处于很好或是很平稳的状态。可是我们可能学一些禅修啊或是静心冥想，就是要让那个波动比较小一点，比较不会高低起伏这么大啊，真的是要去试过，然后长期的去练习下来才会有那些成效。
Generally, every human have a right. Every human have a right to live happily. Every human have a right to live peacefully.In my life, so many people used to ask me the one question, what is the purpose of the living? What is the meaning of the living? I always used to say that live strong and happily. So I introduced this meditation to teach the people how to live strong and happily. To understand the way of the living is very important. This is the meditation, some sort of the methods which can be practiced by the every human.And not only by the practice, also I strongly believe that these practices can change a lot of the people's lifestyle, also a lot of the courage and the peace and happiness in the people's mind.
最后，这些日子来，承蒙你的照顾，希望下次我脆弱的时候能提醒我坚强，请你保重，祝你一切平安。